What up? Welcome back, man. Welcome back to the dojo. It's your boy Nero the Ninja. If you're new, welcome. We're here, man. And Eminem is here. This one is Untouchable. And I feel like a lot of people misinterpreted or misunderstood the point of this song when Eminem released it. And I think I should probably shed some light on it, man. I think one reason was because Joe Budden. I think Joe Budden himself didn't even understand this song. But hey, it is what it is. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Help me get to the goal, man. 3,500 by the end of June, man. So let's get it. Let's try to get that. We can do it. But shout out to everybody that's already subscribed and is supporting and watching all the videos, liking, commenting, man, doing all that good stuff. You guys are awesome. Thank you guys, and I hope everybody's staying safe out there. And yeah, we're gonna let's check it out this out. Of course, I've already heard this, like I said, but I want to give my take on Eminem's the reason why he made this and what he's talking about. But let's get it. Bro, just start. I don't understand how he misinterpreted this song. We won't loot. That's crazy because they're doing that right now.
We ain't gonna lie to you. Black boy, we don't like the sight of you. Pull up on the side of you. Window roll down, profile. Then we wonder why we see this side of you. Probably coming from the dope house. We could let you slide, but your tail light is blue. Out. We know you're hiding that Heidi Klum on you. Another drug charge, homie, it's back inside for you.
So here in this verse, I think he's rapping in the point of view of like a cop or a white guy, but I'm gonna say this is in the perspective of a cop. So these are what the racist cops be thinking or saying, and that's what he's doing. But I feel like Joe Budden think Eminem himself was saying that. Of course, man, that's not the case.
You're hiding that Heidi Klum on you. Another drug charge, homie, it's back inside for you.
With,
in just in case the chase might as soon, we got the trident, two pistols, you ride it to. We'd be delighted to unload it in your back and walk up and lay that taser on the side of you.
Fucked up, but what the fuck am I to do? I keep telling myself, keep doing like you're doing. No matter how many lives you ruin, it's for the red, white, and blue. Time to go find a new one and split his head right in two.
No one's ever indicted you. Why?
Because you're a
white boy.
Exactly, man. So see, he's saying, hey, these cops you doing that shoot, they shoot you and then they go plant a weapon on you and saying that you were trying to either they plant weapons on you or they plant drugs or something so they could have a reason to say that's the reason why I shot him. But really that wasn't the case.
It is said right too. No one's ever indicted you.
Why? And then you don't get in trouble for it. I think Joe Budden just heard this chorus and misinterpreted the whole song. Because he heard white boy, you're a rock star. So he probably just heard that chorus and just misinterpreted the whole song, bro. And thought he probably think Eminem was like crazy and white.
Black boy, we don't get your culture in. We don't care what our government's done to fuck you over, man. Don't tell us your attitude's a result of that. Roll the gas when you get the chip on your shoulder, Ed. Why you kicking that soda can? Pull your pants up, we brought the roller band. Throw your ass in the band car. You don't have to know our plans or what our intentions are.
we don't care what our government's done to fuck you over. That's crazy.
Get the chip on your shoulder, Ed. Why you kicking that soda can? Pull your pants up, we got the roller band. Throw your ass in the van car. You don't have to know our plans or what our intentions are. Our cars are close to our chest. You better show your hands and put our minds more at ease. You get shot in the thyroid, comply or die, boy. We're fighting a crime war. Here come the swine, trying to clean up the streets from all these minorities.
Trying to clean up the streets from all these minorities. Bro, I can't. This is what these are the things that these cops be out here thinking, man. And I'm not saying it's every cop. I'm talking about these specific type of police officers. Because of course not every police is bad. But these type of officers, man, that's what they be out here thinking.
Crime war, here come the swine, trying to clean up the streets from all these minorities. That's what we call them.
We are all minorities. Really, when you think about it, because white people aren't from this country either, or this continent. But hey,
trying to clean up the streets from all these minorities. That's what we call them pigsties for. They're like eyesores, the police talk to like you're just a-
that's what we call it, pigsty for. They're like eyesores. Pigs. Eminem with the bars, man.
Talk to like you're just a piece of trash.
Feels like we're stuck in a time warp to me. As I kick these facts and get these mixed reactions, as this beat back spins, it's like we're drifting back in to the 60s. Having black skin is risky because this keeps happening. Throughout history, African Americans have been treated like shit, and I admit there have been times where it's been embarrassing to be a white boy.
See, I don't think Joe Budden really heard that part right there. And that's when I first heard this song, that's when I got it. That's when I got what he was doing. I'm like, all right, I see what he's doing. And now he's about to go crazy.
Shit, and I admit there have been times where it's been embarrassing to be a white boy.
You're a rock star. White boy. In your cop car.
I don't listen to it cause my head is like a sieve.
White boy, you're untouchable.
The world's coming to an end, I don't even care.
Nobody can tell me shit cause I'm a
big rock star.
Seems like the average lifespan of
I like the switch right here, bro. This switch is crazy, man.
Seems like the average lifespan of a white man is more than twice than a black lifespan. I wonder sometimes if it has a price scanner. I feel like checking out on life can a skate
price scanner checking out. Dude, even when he's making a song with a message, he's still putting the bars, man. And that's what makes Eminem the best rapper of all time. Like, he fits all the categories, man. It's crazy.
And I wonder sometimes if it has a price scanner. I feel like checking out on life can escape the circumstance. I'd rather hear him say die inward than die outward. Ninja, now it's better disguised banter, but that's life.
Ninja is from die outward.
Die outward. Ninja, now it's better disguised banter, but that's life. Strapped because we're strapped financially and can't find answers. We're applying, but McDonald's seems to be the only franchise that'll hire. So how can we have higher standards as Dallas overshadows the battle for Black Lives Matter? We fight back with violence, but acts like that are black guys on the movement, which makes Black Lives Matter. At cops and cops matter, that's why it's at a stalemate and can't arrive at a compromise. So it's black ops. I wonder if we hire more black cops, the crap stops. The block is our backyards, officer.
No, that's the answer for that, Em. Actually, no, you might be right. But there's... I don't know, M-Man. That might be a solution for real.
I am more black cops. The crap stops. The block is our backyards. Officers, not the crack spot. Call the attack dogs off of this man. You always act all pissed off at us at a traffic stop. fighting bad cops. Fuck it up for the good cops.
Thanks.
Man, stop sending white cops in the black neighborhoods who ain't acclimated to them. Mm. Like that's the way to do it. Who seen some fucking videos of rappers waving guns. Mm. And know nobody black, so they act afraid of us. And that's racism. The fear.
Come on, man. What else do you need to hear? Joe Budden, man.
And know nobody black, so they act afraid of us. And that's racism. The fear that a black face gives them. A subconscious racist. Wait, why are there black neighborhoods? Cause America segregated us, designated us to an area, separated us, sectionated us when we tear it up. The only time attention's paid to us in education.
Come on, man. And he said us, so he's on our side, clearly. Come on, man.
Sectionated us when we tear it up. The only time attention's paid to us. And education sucks, and every day's another Freddie Gray for us. A levy breaks a fuzz. Why is it they treat us like violent? We just want a safe environment for our kids, but can't escape the sirens. Don't take a scientist to see our violent nature lies in the poverty that we face. So the crime rate's the highest in the lowest classes. It's like a razor wire fence we're trapped in. These racial biases that plague our society, which makes our anxiety levels raise every time we see a devil's face. Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my.
Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my. I like that part.
Praise every time we see a devil's face. Lions, tigers, and bears, oh my. It's more like billy clubs and gats. And we really love it when you think we're guilty cause we're black. But you kill each other, bats. You peel each other's caps for silly stuff like hats. Single mother struggling.
Bro, I like that flow that he used right there, bro. Like, he's saying real shit, though.
Bats. You peel each other's caps for silly stuff like hats. Single mother struggling through substance abuse while people with nothing to lose shoot each other for shoes.
Bro, that is real. You peel each other's caps for silly stuff like hats. Single mother struggling through substance abuse while people with nothing to lose shoot each other for shoes. Bro, the rhyme scheme there was crazy too, but dude.
Kill each other,
crazy,
you peel each other's caps for silly stuff like hats. Single mother struggling through substance abuse while people with nothing to lose shoot each other for shoes. Mm. Fuck your Republican views, pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. What a fuck are the boots?
Mm.
And streets act as a narrator. Don't gotta read comics or be that into characters. Just to see that, just to be black, you better be strapped with a derringer or be Captain America like Steve.
Ooh, or be Captain America? Bro, I didn't get that before. Oh, shit. Be Captain America, but Captain America? Ooh. Bro, that's a bar.
Just to be black, you better be strapped with a derringer or be Captain America like Steve Rogers. Cause no one oversees these cops, and all we see is them beat charges. We done seen them beat Rodney King unconscious and got off. So we don't need all you crooked police officers' peace offerings. Just keep marching till we reach Congress. But they're gonna say you're trying to take an irrational stance if you try to slander the flag. But somebody has to be the sacrificial lamb, so they call it a Kaepernick tantrum if you don't stand for the national anthem.
And now the what's his name? Something Goodall or Goodall, Roger Goodell, Goodall, something, I don't know, the NFL president or whatever he is, coming out here talking about Black Lives Matter and, bro, you better go apologize to Kaepernick. Bro, these corporations, man, they only care about stuff when it gets huge and their business is at risk. That's when they come and try to put out a statement and saying that they stand with us. But when Colin Kaepernick was out here kneeling, y'all blackballed him out of the league, bro. Imagine if all these football players just said, F it, man. all the African American football players or black football players say, F it. Bro, your league is over. It's done for. Cause like I think more than 70% of the NFL is black. Like, dude, y'all crazy.
We raise it, you better praise it, or you'll be made to feel like a traitor will. Treat you like Rodney Dangerfield, home of the bravest still, Racistville. So this whole nation feels like a plantation field. In a country that claims that its foundation was based on United States ideals that had its natives killed. Got you singing this star-spangled spiel to a piece of cloth that represents a land of the free that made people slaves to build.
Come on, man. Come on, man. That's a great way to end it. United States ideals that had its natives killed got you singing this star-spangled spiel. Where's he talking about that? The anthem. To a piece of cloth that represents the land of the free. That made people slaves to build. The land of the free, but y'all made people slaves. Come on, man. That's crazy. But yo, that was Eminem, man. Untouchable. Like I said, man, I think people misinterpreted this song, misunderstood the purpose of it, but I didn't. I got it from like the first time I heard it. Like I said a few minutes ago, at that specific point of the song is where I got it. And yeah, man, shout out to Eminem for that. Eminem is one of the realest dudes, man, so shout out to him. And yeah, stay tuned for more videos, man. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, comment, let me know what else to check out, and I'm gonna catch you guys next one.